morning I'm going to show you how I make a print of this old linoleum block mounted on particle board, but I've probably had this for 20 years. But I thought it would be fun to try a new print of it because it's meant to be hand colored, and then I can also show the hand coloring. So to start with the process of printing, I'm going to roll out ink first. And I find these disposable aluminum cookie sheets to be perfectly good for rolling out ink. Make sure it's all clean. And then I'm going to take my Cranfield Caligo Safe Wash Relief Ink, black, which is almost used up, but there's still plenty of good stuff in here. Clean it off a little bit too. And then I'm going to squeeze a line of it along the top one end of the cookie sheet. I'm going to get out quite a bit because I hope to make four prints. My paper is soaking right there in the tray, and before I even roll out the ink, I'll take out one sheet of paper and let it start to dry. This is Arches Cover. It's a great combo paper. It's good for printmaking and it's also good for watercoloring. And this is going to be a hand colored print. So I'll take an ink knife . Spread out my ink a little bit and then pull some down the tray. And then I'll grab a brayer, just a simple rubber rolling pin, hard but not super hard. And I'll roll it in the ink. So my goal here is to create a layer of ink on this tray. I may not have enough yet. That will be just the right thickness. I don't want it too thick because then it could fill in some of the little small bits on here. And I want it thick enough and then there to be enough ink that it will cover and make a really nice black print. So, not sure if you can hear this. Sort of a scratchy sound, and the surface that you want to achieve has sort of a velvety sheen, a little bit of a nap, but not too much. Now my brayer is also evenly covered with ink. I'm going to move this over here, pull down my work area, and I put my block on a paper towel because if I were to fall off the block somehow and get ink on the paper towel, I can always discard it, but I don't want to throw this piece of paper away. And now I'm just applying ink to the surface. I'll go back and grab more. My squeaky brayer. When you ink a block, you want to be careful to get every corner, and you can turn your brayer any way you want in order to achieve that. If you feel you can't turn your brayer enough, you can always turn your block. So there at that corner, needs a little bit more. And when I think I'm almost done, but I'm not sure, the way I gauge it is I pick up my block and I look at it at an angle and I see if every area is shiny. and that means it has some ink on it. I'm going to give this another. Another go around just to be sure. And I'm going to put my brayer down to rest on its back so it doesn't get any pressure on the rubber part. And come over here and smooth the paper. What you want with paper is the reason to soak it is it softens it up and allows it to emboss better. And this arches has two sides. One is more pebbly than the other. This is the pebbly side, what I would call the good side. Actually, did I just mix that up? Yeah, I did. Okay, this is the pebbly side. This is the not pebbly side. Okay, so you can see some texture on that paper. And now I'm going to take the block and place it right here where I've outlined its dimensions. And then I'm going to take the paper and holding it by two corners, I'm going to hover it over and drop it down, hopefully straight. Then I just use my hands for the very first step, pressing, and you can already see some embossing happening. That's good. And then I'm going to use my new tool from Iron Frog Press, and it's a glass baron. It's about 2 pounds and fits really nicely in my hand, and you just plop it on there and start rubbing with the baron. I can also use a wooden spoon. There are other kinds of barons. These are not cheap, but I figured I'm worth it. And again, if you don't want to turn your hand, just turn your block. More comfortable, I'm right-handed, so it's more comfortable for me to hold the print with one hand while I rub the baron with the other. And just as I do when I ink, I want to work my way all the way around the border. You can make either up and down, back and forth, or circular motions, it doesn't really matter. Now, if you think you've got a good print, that's probably, 15 seconds I've been spending on this? You can pull back a corner and see if you've got a nice black. Looks like I do. So, I'm going to pull the print. It turned out great. You can see there's little areas of embossing where there was chatter that didn't have any ink on it. And those will catch paint in a nice way. But I'm very happy with it.